There's still a number of challenges that we face in mantle cell lymphoma. One of the first ones is that the median age at diagnosis is the mid to late 60s, so that's only difficult for intensive therapy. We still don't really know if high dose therapy auto is beneficial after induction therapy, and particularly in a patient who are MRD negative. And achieving a deep response, CR and MRD negative early in mantle cell lymphoma matters. And this is being looked at in a triangle study in France, where they're looking at induction, the same induction that they had in the past, and with or without and transplant, and replacing the transplant by a maintenance ibrutinib. So those are options, trying to see if we really need to do the high dose therapy. And then I would say the third challenge is a subset of patients that present with a really blastoid variant, high proliferative disease, and complex karyotype, and p53 mutated, and this patient can do very poorly, and that's where also the CAR T cell, the ZUMA-2 trial ongoing, seems very promising, will be an option for this patient, either by itself or as a bridge towards an allo transplant after they fail induction therapy.